Hey, what's up, y'all? This is Alan. I'm finishing up this vertical smoker I did the video on the other day. This is just a firebox door I'm getting laid out. I've been jumping back and forth between this one and those reverse flows and another reverse flow. Probably have a video on it too. This is just getting the lip around the door, measuring it all out and putting it on. I've got another reverse flow going now that I'm trying to do something a little different with the firebox. I wish it wouldn't have been already half built. I actually had it built a little over a year ago and just never did finish it. And I wish I wouldn't have had as much done as I did so I could do other things, but it's something to look forward to on a new video. It's coming soon. I just kind of been messing with it a little bit, mostly getting the rust off of it from it sitting there. Trying to open those gaps up in the corners. If you got that flat bar butted up right against each other with no gap, it don't really weld that good. It'll weld over the top and you'll get some burn in, but if you open that gap up, it'll do a little better. And this is the vent that I'm laying out. I like to tack those on and then just cut through both of them at the same time. You can put it on there and just put your little pilot hole in and then do them separate though. But that HTP, it handles it pretty good. This is an Evolution mag drill. I got a video coming up on it in a couple days. Most of it was done in the other shop, so some of it will be there, some of it will be here. But this is a great drill. I'm telling you, I wish I would have got it a long time ago. And I don't even have the annular cutters, the plug cutters for it. I'm just using regular bits. But this is cutting out the vent, and that's doing them at the same time. I mean, you couldn't get too thick with it. The door is 1/4 inch, and the vents are 11 gauge. So you got about 3/8 thickness that it's going through. It needs to be good and flat, tight against each other though. And you need your consumables to be good. If they're kind of wore, it'll give you a pretty good bevel sometimes. I had one time I just had to redo all together. And we're getting the door put on. This smoker's just about done. The other stuff is done. It's just I gotta put it on. I tack the hinges and then check them just to make sure that it's still moving. Got it finished up and now I'm painting it. I still haven't got my overhang done on the back of it. I don't know when I'm gonna get it done. So I just rolled out here on the plywood and paint right now. I'll come back after that dries and get another coat on it. I'm gonna go ahead and start cutting out stuff for this other reverse flow. This is the chamber, the horizontal chamber. Actually, I already have the vertical chamber done on it. It's just the panels for the sides of it and everything. I wish I was actually moving as fast as it looks and fast forward like this. I can rip them out really quick then. That little weight that I'm using in the middle, that's a good thing to have on hand for a lot of stuff. That's just a piece of, I think it's either 1.5 inch or 2 inch. I think it's 1.5 inch steel. A plug that I think I found it at the steel yard maybe and kept it and just put a little handle on it. And I use that weight for so much stuff. It probably weighs 2 or 3 pounds, maybe. I don't know, I've never weighed it. Getting this chamber welded out, and then that's the vertical chamber for it. I'll probably come back and do a video on those too. Just moving on to the next one while the paint was drying on that vertical. And I got it all wrapped up. This is it. This is a 24 by 24 vertical. It's built with 1/4 inch steel. Has 8 inch wheels. This one has a temp port on it and a log ladder on it. You can add those if you want it. It has 4 racks in it, the drip pan, a diverter plate, coal rack, and the ash pan. I'll leave my email in the description box if you're looking for a smoker. You can shoot me an email and I'll get back to you. If you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe and come back for the next one.